In this tutorial video, we will explain how to properly install your Helix QAC license server. Once you've installed your software and started it, you should have gotten a message like the one on the screen that there are no licenses for many of your products and you need to install a license server. Normally, the license server is hosted on a central IT machine. We'll be demonstrating the installation of that. In your packet of information that you receive from us, you would have gotten some download links. Once you have access to the download site, which is at products.prqa.com, you should have direct links to them. In this case, the link would take you to the Reprise License Manager. From there, you would pick the version. You would probably download the installation guide and then download the Reprise License Manager installation. As you can see, we have gotten a license from the company and an installation guide. Installing on Windows is very straightforward, but we also have information on Linux installations and other background information. But for our example, we'll be going through the installation process on a Windows environment. As you will see, we just need to run the installation program. Go to Default, which is now the Perforce RLM 14.2, and hit Next. While that's installing, let's discuss that the license that you're getting is most likely an authorized user license, which will allow each person to have access to the tool at any moment in time. Only the individual that the license is allocated to can access that particular license. Once you run the installer, you'll see that what we end up having is the RLM 14.2. We have created an administrator command prompt. From here, you can see that the installation has a very few number of items. The service that we provide is this .exe. The main service that needs to be started is rlm.exe, and it normally runs through a service, which we'll show you the installation of here in just a few seconds. Let's go back to the RLM installation directory, the DIR, to see the various executables. Type in rlm --help, which will give you the command line that you need to create. You can do more than what we're going to show you. What we're asking the system to do is to put the dlog for a debug log in the RLM installation directory to install the service with a service name of rlm_helixqac_server. You can rearrange this for your wants, but we recommend RLM and our name so that it will be recognizable by your IT staff. Now, if we go to the services console and refresh, go to the R's, you can see that there is an RLM Helix QAC service server. All we need to do now is to run. If there's an admin site that's been set up and you see that it's at localhost.5054, which is not the port that you'll use for your license, but it cannot be reached at the moment. If we start the service, we can check on the admin interface. This is controllable by your IT staff, who can have access to it and so forth. You can look at the admin documentation in the installation to adjust that as necessary. However, this is useful to you as a developer because you can come in here and see what the status of the server is. As you can see, there's no ISV servers running, and that's because we want to show you what happens if you don't have a license in the directory. All we need to do is paste that in here. We could restart the server from the command services dialog, but we can also come in here, hit the reread restart, and reread start. Once it comes back, you can go back to the status button. You should see now that the ISV service, the PRQA executable that we were talking about, is running. It's on this port, which is 5055. Let's restart the service and then go back to the status. You'll see that the port that's in your license file is 5055, which is the main port that you'll be using. Now, you can look at the configuration, and there's a debug log that's the dlog, as specified on the command line. The license file in this directory is the temporary license file. If we bring this up in a notepad, you'll see that the licenses that we showed on screen a few seconds ago are in here. If you have multiple users, the way to understand this is that we have different features for the tool, Helix QAC, a GUI tool in terms of an older version of our software. For the current version, this message browser license will be pulled if we're looking at results. When you're running the parser, this will be used, and if you're running a baseline or so forth, that license will be pulled. For QAC++, If you purchase both analyzers, you'll have that. And then for each of the compliance modules, there is M2CM, which is the 2004 MISRA standard. Then the 2012 is M3CM. We also have CERT-C, CERT-C++, MISRA-C++, a CWE, and CWE-C++. You can find the vulnerabilities for security. MITRE has been maintaining a list of. Then, of course, you have your QAV server and client licenses. In each case, the number following the expiration date is the number of licenses that you have. In this case, you have one server license and then six people who can look at the dashboard server. That would give you an idea of how to install, set up, and run the server. When you're in here, you'll notice that there's nothing that's in use at the moment. Let's go back to our software. If we go to the admin, manage license servers, and then back to the 5055 that we discussed earlier, when we do that, we see that all of these are available. We specifically created this with some licenses for tools that we haven't licensed in this license file, and you can see those there. Let's clean this project using the C parser, and as you can see, we were successful. If we go back to the tool and refresh the page, you'll see that a couple of things have happened. The first one is that the message browser and the parser have had checkouts made against them. If you look in here, you'll see that I now have checked out one of the licenses for the message browser, and the same thing would be true for the parser. So we've allocated this license and ours indefinitely. If we remove ourselves from this, that would be fine as somebody else could take over this slot, but we wouldn't be able to get a license again for 10 calendar days. In any case, we have successfully set up the server. We have created the service that starts it automatically. If the system reboots, it should start automatically as well. You can use this graphical user interface to check on the status of licenses. Additionally, you can shut down and reread things from here, and run diagnostics and look at the manual. For more information on how to get the most out of your static analysis tool, visit our library of guided tutorial videos.